Hi guys, I am Dr. Sunil Sharma. Now this is my fourth video. Now we will talk about skull. Okay. Decoding of head and neck for ENTPs and NEET. Now skull. The part one I am going through exterior and general part of the skull. Now skull is made up of 28 bones according to Gray anatomy. Okay. 28 bone. It's divided into two parts, that is mandible 1 and cranium, also called calvaria. Calvaria again divided into two parts, cranial vault, also called neurocranium, that is having 8 bone, I will tell you, and viscerocranium, that is also called skull base, it's having two parts, ear ossicles having 6, and remaining viscerocranium plus mandible form the facial skeleton, 14. So this is how it forms. Skull is this skull, this whole is called skull. If you see extend from this chin to the foramen magnum, that occipital condyles, and up to the vertex below up to the chin, this is the extent of this skull. Okay, this is whole is skull. Mandible include in the skull, hyoid bone is not included in the skull. Okay, remember this. This is base, all about basic of the skull. Now what is the definition of skull? Okay, the skull is bony covering of brain, meninges, CSF, special sense organs like ear, nose, tongue. Okay, bony covering, brain, meninges, CSF, special sense organ, and upper aerodigestive tract. So if you see, it's skull, whole skull. It's also cover the upper part of the eating and airway, that is food pipe and windpipe. This is called the definition. It's part of axial skeleton. Axial skeleton. Part of axial skeleton. This is brain, meninges, CSF, and special sense organ. This is whole. This up to mandible. This is called skull. Okay, above the atlas, whatever it moving is called skull. Okay, now extent of skull is, if you see extent of skull up to the vertex below foramen magnum. Foramen magnum, condyles, occipital condyles, and laterally from chin, mandible, up to the external occipital protuberance. It means whatever above the atlas is whole skull. Okay, this is whole skull. You can see this, it's having 28 bones. Now, what are the most important aspects? Now, we will talk about neurocranium. Neurocranium. It's also called cranial vault, having 8 bone. You just have to understand the bone, don't have to make any mnemonics and anything else. Just I will tell you how. If you count total 8 bones, if you see this, this is the frontal, parietal, temporal, occipital, and this nose, behind this nose is ethmoid, and base having that sphenoid bone. So how will count total total 8 bones. Now if you see paired bones, only having temporal bone and parietal. Unpaired part of neurocranium, sphenoid, ethmoid, frontal and occipital. See, this is 4 and this is pair 2, total 8. Okay, so this is how paired bone are in neurocranium: temporal bone, parietal bone, sphenoid, ethmoid, frontal and occipital. You have to understand this. This is frontal bone 1, this is occipital bone 1, these are two parietal bones. Okay, see, these are two parietal bones, this is one frontal and this is two temporal bones. See, this is temporal and this is temporal. If you see, this is the sphenoid one, sphenoid one, and behind this nose you can see, this is above, this is ethmoid one. Okay, so this is all about neurocranium. Now ear ossicles. Ear ossicles 3 on each side. Okay, so you just malleus, incus and stapes into towards 6 bones. Okay, now this is 6 bone. Malleus, incus, stapes, ear ossicle found in the middle ear. This is the smallest bone of the body. Total bone 206. Okay, we have human body having 206 total bones. Smallest is stapes bone. Now we will talk about facial skeleton. Facial skeleton. Okay. Facial skeleton having total 14 bones. Okay. You just understand it. See, this is nasal bone. Behind this lacrimal, this is maxillary, zygomatic, mandible, vomer and inferior ethmoid and palatine bone. This is so simple. Now, unpaired vomer, mandible. Okay, 2 bone. Unpaired vomer and mandible. Now we will talk about paired facial skeleton. Now we will start from this nasal. This is nasal. Okay. Behind this, if you see lacrimal, and from here you can see this is maxilla. Lateral to this, this is zygoma. If you see in the nose, inferior turbinate, inferior terminate is separate bone. It is not like it's like middle and superior terminate are the part of the isthmoid bone, but this is the separate bone. And last one is peritoneal bone. These are paired bones. So this is 12, okay, and this is 2, total 14 bones. Now I will revise it again. See, there is 2 unpaired bones in the facial skeleton. This is mandible, and inside the nose one bone, this form the bony septum. This is bomber, okay. This you can see, this you can see film, and above this you have cartilaginous bony septum, but this is bomber, okay. So two bones, bomber and mandible, okay. This is mandible, this is bomber. Now talk about paired bone. Paired, if you see nasal bones, most common bone of the facial with fracture, that is most common fractured bone in the facial skeleton, okay, nasal bone. Then you can see this is lacrimal bone, okay. This is frontal process of maxilla, this is lacrimal bone. This is, if you see, this is lacrimal bone, okay. And now come to this is maxilla and this is zygoma, okay. If you see this bone, this is inferior terminate, and if you rotate this, okay, you see this is palatine bone, okay. This is all about facial skeleton. Now it's having proto bones. So many MCQs can be asked, 22, 20 and 40. Answer should be, according to gray anatomy, should be 28. Most common MCQ it can be asked. If they will ask about neurocranium, it's having 8 bone. Yeah, if ask about cranial vault, that is having cover the neurocranial part, having 8 bones. Facial skeleton, 14 bone. What is paired, what is unpaired, I have already told you. Okay. Now development, okay. Development, if you see, all bones develop from mesenchyme. This mesenchyme is coming from mainly neural crest cells, lateral plate, mesoderm, and para axial mesoderm. Okay, this mesenchyme coming from neural crest cell, lateral plate, mesoderm, paraxial mesoderm. Okay, if you see this, if we draw line from vertex to this mastoid process, we can divide this anterior to this vertex is developed from the neural crest cell, and posterior to this all bones develop from paraxial mesoderm and lateral plate mesoderm. Okay. This mesenchyme having two type of ossifications. Okay, this mesenchyme convert into chondroblast, or it can convert into osteoblast. Whatever bone develop from this chondroblast is called endochondral ossification. And whatever bone developed from osteoblasts are called intramembranous ossification. Okay, mainly frontal occipital and parietal bone develop from the osteoblast intramembranous ossification and chondroma mainly viscerocranium, that is sphenoid, ethmoid, and most or all temporal, some part of temporal bone like pneumatic part develop from endochondral ossification. Okay, and this is about mesenchyme, and some part of the skeletal skull develop from first and second pharyngeal arch, like mandible develop from first arch, maxilla also develop from first arch, and malleus of the ear, malleus and incus. First arch, malleus, incus, and second arch is tibialis. Okay, these all about development of the skull. So development: paraxial mesoderm, lateral plate mesoderm, neural crest cells also called fourth germ cell layer. Neural crest cells also called fourth germ cell layer, and first and secondary pharyngeal arch form the skull. Now some important point on skull. If we see exterior of the skull, okay, this region, this is coronal suture, this is sagittal suture, this is coronal, this is sagittal suture. Okay, this is lambdoid suture. This part where the coronoid and sagittal suture is meeting is called bregma. This is skull. This is coronal suture. This is sagittal suture. And this is coronal suture. Okay, this point is called bregma or anterior fontanelle. Okay, bregma anterior fontanelle, it's ossified or close at 18th month. Now this region where lambdoid and sagittal suture meets, this is called posterior fontanelle. This closes at 2 to 3 months. Okay, now what is the significance of this? This, if it is, if intracranial pressure increases in new nets, it will show as a bulge in the intracranial pressure. If it is deepens, okay, then it shows as a sign of dehydration. It's sign of dehydration. Okay, now 3.5 centimeter above this is called, there is two foramen formed, that is called parietal foramen. This parietal foramen transmit the emissary vein from scalp to the superior sagittal sinus. Okay, now I will tell you. See, this is bregma and this is posterior fontanelle, or this is lambdoid suture. 3.5 centimeter to this. See, this is, both are these,
This is artificial skull, that's why not prominent. These are two parietal foramens. Okay, this transmit the emissary beam. And this in between two parietal foramen is one point is called ovarium. Okay, here this point is called, between these two parietal foramen is called ovarium. Ovarium. Okay, and this point, this is external occipital protuberance. Okay, this prominent part. Here the one point is called inion. Okay, see this inion. Inion. And these are supraorbital margin, and above this is foramen, it's called supraorbital foramen. And this superciliary arch which merges in the midline is called glabella. Okay, this region is called glabella. These are common points which can be asked in the exam. Now next time we will talk about skull base, and just I am briefing about skull base. A lot of guys don't know what is the skull base. Okay, so skull base is extrude from upper incisor it's extrude from upper incisor to posteriorly this is external occipital protuberance. Okay, external occipital protuberance from superior temporal line to foramen magnum or occipital condyle. This is extent of skull base. See, from here incisor, this is incisor teeth to this occipital protuberance. It means parietal bone are not included in the skull base. All bones frontal from the orbital plate of anterior cranial fossa, and occipital also form the base of the posterior cranial fossa. So all bone except parietal bone include in the skull base. Now also mandible is not included in the skull base. So upper incisor here, if you remove, I have already removed the mandible. So from here incisor to external occipital protuberance, laterally if you see this mustard process, zygoma, okay, and this temporal bone, except parietal, all bone are included in the skull base. Thank you so much. Next time I will tell you about extent of the skull base and detail about entry of the skull. Okay.